Hey guys, what's up? It's Amanda. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video. Today is the last video for 2022 and it is our January budget, starting off the new year with a new budget. Today is gonna be a little bit different, and starting from now on it's gonna be a tiny bit different because I have actually started using the Every Dollar app to budget for mine and Alex's joint account as well. I talked about this in my finance like recap for the year, that we were really bad about spending money, and I was keeping track of it, but I was just not doing what I was supposed to be doing, so it's fine. We were like a little bit net negative. We had some extra savings that we used, but anyway, we are keeping track of that. So I will also be going into depth and going through December and January budget for my and Alex's joint account. So that'll be the second part of this video. So for now, we're gonna start with my budget. If you don't know, my name is Amanda. I am a 26-year-old nurse. I had a baby, she's down there, in September and December, well, end of November. December was my first month going back to work. So the last few budgets have been a little funky because I wasn't having my full income. But you guys, we are back to work. We are back to normal paychecks. Life is amazing. Working is a struggle sometimes. Like, I would rather just hang out with her all day, but we gotta make money somehow. And it has been all worth it. But anyway, I have a few updates I have to make and put some like purchases in. Hello Miko, you come to say hello again. I have to update a few things and put some things in, but then we will go through my budget. All right, so like I said before, December was my first month back at work, and I also had changed around my like tax withholding and stuff because I have having a baby, and I changed around my, and then my insurance increased a little bit, so I wasn't sure what my paychecks were gonna do, but I was pleasantly surprised. So you take a gander. My first paycheck back at work, I had like a few days that I was unpaid for maternity leave, so it ended up being a little less than I was planning. But the next two paychecks, okay, we're gonna talk about the first one. So the first one, I think this is just gonna be kind of my norm. I didn't work any extra. I think that this is just kind of gonna be where things are at now, which I can't complain about. We'll see what happens with taxes next year, but that's okay. And then AdSense, I ended up making more than I had planned. And then your girl worked Christmas. Oh, sorry, that's supposed to be you. That's supposed to be it too. Your girl worked Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, and they are both weekend shifts, and they are both PM shifts. So I was making like $70 an hour or so for those 16 hours. So my paycheck today that I got for this last 2 weeks, I'm just very happy with that. Yes, working Christmas was shitty and I wish I didn't have to do that, but it was worth it for the money. Like, I was compensated fairly for it, if that makes sense. So right now I had just my like leftover money for the year going, or for the month going, to my savings account, and we will change that in a minute and update it when we're done with this. But I have been transferring my AdSense money to save for weddings and stuff that's coming up this summer. So that is there. I'll talk about this when me and Alex, or when I go through my joint account with Alex, but I have increased the amount that I am putting there just because of what we've been spending money on, and we kind of just reconfigured things, and I'll go through that in a little bit. It's gonna be $2,300 typically. I just had, our debit card wasn't working at the grocery store, so I had to use my debit card. So instead of transferring more money, I just like kept that as the way it was, if that makes sense. So it's a tiny bit more, but it's good. I think what had happened was my credit card statement was higher than what I had owed, so that was weird there, but I think the rest of this is good. Miscellaneous, I just went a tiny bit over, and it wasn't necessarily like anything bad. I just had forgotten to Venmo my mom for she got
Migo, bless you.
She had gotten us a snowblower from my aunt, and I just had to pay her back for it. So that was there. It's just because Venmo is a tech connected to my bank account, so it is what it is. Christmas presents, guys. I did so good. I overestimated how much I was gonna spend on Christmas presents, and I am very happily surprised, and I am happy that I did what I could. And then Planet Fitness, that one. So that puts us, we're just gonna zero this, being able to put like $2,000 or so into our savings account, which is really exciting. I just need to remember to do that. So that's super exciting. And then that's actually gonna go to our joint savings account, because if you watched my finance video, we're trying to save up to a month and a half to 2 months worth of finances and expenses. That's one of our goals for this year. And then we're gonna start saving, putting money towards my student loan. So that's exciting once we hit that. So let's create our January budget for my joint account, or for my checking account. So obviously we don't have 3 paychecks, which boo, sad, but it's fine. I'm just gonna do $2,150, because I feel like this is a fluke. Like, I feel like I really don't make that much money. So we're just gonna underestimate a little bit, and we'll see. Cause like I said, my first paycheck of December was a little funky because I had a few days where I didn't work. The second one I think is my normal, but then the third one I had Christmas. So that one was higher, so I don't wanna over budget, so it's fine. AdSense, I feel like we are in the realm of $100. We're in the realm of $100 for the month. We're at $140 right now, so I'll just do that. And then we'll do that. And then savings will be zero for now. Joint account, so it'll be $2,300. So it'll be $1,150 a month. Credit card, I think. Guys, it was good while it lasted, not having to use my credit card, not having to pay for gas, but now that I go to work again, it's right back up there. My credit score actually decreased like a point because I started using my credit card again for gas, but it's fine. Oh geez, $160. Oh, we also drove kind of far away. Okay, that should all be the same. We don't need to buy no Christmas presents. Miscellaneous, we're gonna do $150. I honestly don't think I'm gonna end up spending anything with that, but it's fine. And then we have $425 left, which is exciting because that means I can put that in my savings. And that is our January budget, which honestly, it's getting so quick to just fill this out. I don't think I have anything major coming up in January. I should like look at my calendar and make sure that we don't have anything going on. Oh, did I do that for December? We do have my holiday work party, which is $60. I think I paid for that already, but I don't remember if I put it in or not. So I'm just gonna put it here because I'm sure we'll get more stuff while we're there too. Our joint checking account, which Alex and I sat down, we made out a budget, we went through what we had been spending and stuff like that, and kind of estimated where we think we're gonna be at, and this is kind of the budget we came up with. Prior to this, I had an Excel spreadsheet, well, Google Drive spreadsheet, whatever, that I was keeping track of our expenses, but I would forget to update it, and it was just so much work, and it's hard because I couldn't do it from my phone, whatever. And yeah, it wasn't working to actually keep track of what we were spending. Like, it was fine for like an overall review, but whatever. So here we are. This is our joint account, so this does not include Alex's separate checking account. And let's just dive into it. So as you can see, I'm transferring more money in than Alex. I make more money than Alex. It's fair. It is what it is. Whatever. Who cares? Get over it. It's 2022, almost 2023. So this is just what it is. Whatever. My second transfer technically was only $1,000 though, so we will do that. And then we had a transfer for savings, and this stuff is whatever. For some reason, my PayPal for brand deals is set up to our joint account, so it's fine. But I had some paid brand deals, so that went to our checking, which is awesome. Okay, so then we have our emergency fund. For some reason, the way our like account is, we have to have $25 transfer from our checking to our savings every month. So that's there for now. And then I'll add more when we're done. But our mortgage is there, our water and electricity, this is what it's gonna be, but we haven't paid it yet, so I'm just gonna leave that blank. Our gas, our internet went up a little bit because we were getting fiber, so we had to pay like an installation fee. It's fine though. And then our gas bill was a little bit less than what we had budgeted for. This will be the same. I think everything else is good. Our auto insurance comes out twice a year, so I kind of made it like a sinking fund, so we don't pay it, but it's there. Groceries, we technically spent less, but that was because I I don't think I've updated some of these things yet. Okay, never mind. The only thing I just haven't updated was dinner that we got the other night. Okay. So, groceries, there we are. Restaurants, we budgeted $75, but we only ended up spending $38.22. We have a bad habit of buying things on Amazon and then not remembering, because on our checking account it just tells us like Amazon however much money we spent. So I've been trying to categorize what we're spending and why, because usually it falls into three categories: Amelia things, house things, cat things. So I kind of estimated a budget for every month, I guess, to figure out what, I don't know. So Amelia had $100 in her budget, but we did not spend that much. We only spent half of that, so cool. Home things ended up being more because we had to buy our blinds and we bought like a fridge filter or whatever. Pet care ended up being more because we were due for litter and cat food, whatever. Miscellaneous, you guys, we had previously been spending like over $500 a month on Amazon on just like random shit. Not random shit, stuff we needed, but just stuff we didn't need, but stuff we needed, you know, like frivolous spending a little bit. So, we did really good this month. We did very good. I'm very proud of us. Okay, so we have $547 left to budget. So that's gonna go to our emergency fund. And I just need to remember to put that in, but whatever, not a big deal. So that's kind of our budget. That's kind of where we're at with things. That's for December. January, we're gonna do the same thing. The thing that sucks is I don't know how to fix this, but it's fine. So $150, transfer from savings won't happen. Alex doesn't need to transfer any money for Christmas presents, brand deals, nada. And this goes back to $25. Mortgage is the same, water and electricity. I don't know if we got our bill yet for next month. No, I don't have my bill yet for next month. So we'll just go $160 because that's kind of where it should be. Gas, we've been budgeting that one. This one, I think we're still paying one more month of regular internet. Actually, no, that's a lie. It's gonna go up, $79.99. Inner, Spotify, Disney Plus, that's all the same. That's all the same. Groceries, what did we have last time? $550, I believe. Restaurants, shouldn't need to buy any car things. Home things are $100. Amelia things $100. Pet stuff $50. Restaurants $100. I'm short some money. Oh, miscellaneous was $1. Okay, we got more money. Where is this supposed to go? This is where it's gonna go. We eventually are gonna have to start paying for daycare for Amelia too, so that's gonna change what we spend and how we spend it and everything. But so that is our budget for January. That is my checking account and Alex and mine joint account. And yeah, I'm hoping that keeping track of mine and Alex's spending in our joint account helps, because it helps keep me accountable for what we've been spending and everything. And I hope that 2023 is an abundant year for us in terms of money. And I am very excited that I'm have been making more money, because that just, it's nice. Like, you can't say you don't like money, you know? Anyway, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to Amelia for being chill this whole time and letting me film. Love her. And yeah, I will see you guys in 2023. I feel like, I think I'm gonna take like a week. I mean, I've kind of been only been uploading every week, but once a week. But I'm gonna take a week, a little bit over a week, and I'm thinking my next video will be up on Wednesday or Tuesday the 10th. One of those 2 days is gonna be until I figure out my next upload schedule. We're working on it. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.